The Diary of a Queen, Chapter 1. 16th Birthday Morning. Today's my birthday. I love celebrating my birthday at the palace. There will be a huge festival in my honor. Okay, I need to get ready. First things first. I need to get dressed. Which dress should I wear today? Is that even a question? Of course, my gold and purple dress. Emma, I called. Yes, my lady, she answered, ready to help me in any way she can. What should I do about my hair and makeup? She looked up, debating. I think a classic braid bun with makeup more on the natural side, she suggested. Great idea. I sat in the chair in front of my vanity as she started on my makeup and hair. For your hair accessory, I was thinking not exactly a royal crown because you're still a princess, but instead, Emma held up a golden flower crown with purple accents. Oh my, Emma, you made this for me? I responded in awe. Yes, what do you think? Emma asked. I think it's so beautiful, you could start a war over it. Speaking of war, today is a perfect day to relax and forget about the war against the realm of the spears, I said, matter-of-factly, as she set the crown on my head. There, a beautiful princess. Thanks, Emma. It's my duty to fulfill all your requests, Your Highness. Why does she still call me that after I made it clear that she can call me by my first name? Maybe for prosperity. Emma, you can just call me Hayden. No formalities needed. Yes, miss. You should go greet your family downstairs. I head downstairs, and when I get to the banquet hall where my family eats our meals every day, the air instantly hits me with the smell of bacon and eggs. I made it, just in time to see my mother waiting for me with my younger sister, Leilani. Other lords and ladies of the court were seated, waiting for my father, the king, to bless the food. Hello, dear. Happy birthday. Thanks, Mom. I see the food set on the table reserved for the members of the royal family and guests. You must be very hungry, dear. Enjoy some food. I had the chefs pick out your favorites. Dear, my mother always called me that. My mother, Leilani, and I took our seats at the head table as my father enters the room and my mother and the rest of the court stands back up. No need to rise. Enjoy this festival for a day and relax. Take your mind off the war. My father blessed the food and we ate. Food at the palace tastes so good. The bacon and eggs are cooked to perfection. The eggs have the best cheese and mouth-watering ham in it. I finish my food before anyone else, and as I'm on my way, I give my father a hug. Happy birthday, my princess, he said in a proud-like voice. Thanks, father. As I'm walking through the halls to go check on the garden party decor for later, I run into Dusk, the son of the lord and lady of the House of Onyx. Your Highness, Dusk says, as he lowers into a bow. Sir Dusk, how are you today? I asked, formally acknowledging him. Excellent. How about you, Your Highness? He said, after coming out of his bow. In high spirits, because it's my birthday, and I don't have to sit through boring lectures about war, I responded matter-of-factly. I burst out laughing, as does Dusk. Dang, you nail formalities, he said, still laughing. I mean, still, no boring meetings. I have like a half hour before I meet it again. Let's go to the garden or something, I said, desperate to catch a break from royal life with my best friend. Emma is also my very good friend, but she acts like she doesn't know how to have fun. Lead the way, my lady, he said, with that last part jokingly as if I was his lover or something. As I started walking, a frantic butler came around the corner. Your Highness, I found you at last! You are needed in the great room at once, the butler cried. Crap, sorry, Dusk. I can find time to hang out later, I said with a disappointed expression on my face. I get it. You're the heir to the throne and all that, he said also with a disappointed face. It looks as if he had something important he wanted to tell me. I guess whatever it is, it will have to wait till the party. Thank you for listening. This was Chapter 1 of The Diary of a Queen, storyline by Eve Lynn.